get ready to start the program. Good morning.
Morning.
Boy, it's been a long time since we've seen each other, hasn't it? I ain't seen a crowd like this since I was at the Giant Eagle window shopping for groceries. Welcome, thank you. And your parents, thank you for having the children to join us today. And I know you have children in the band, the Mighty Indians Marching Drill Team Band. Welcome, all of you. Today, I just want to bring up one before I get into my remarks, which will be very short. Today marks one of our members in 1971, one of our members of the VFW here. I didn't know him, but I knew his father and his family. It was Paul Urquhart. He's from Peters Township. And in 1971, he's a helicopter pilot. He got shot down in Vietnam. It took a while for his remains to be found and identified. And he's on our wall of valor in the VFW. VFW Memorial Day Remembrance. Friends, I would like to remind each and every one of you of the somber reason for Memorial Day. We must not forget the service members buried in hollow grounds throughout the country and around the world. For many in our nation, this Memorial Day weekend will be like a breath of fresh air. As more and more of this past year's restrictions are lifted across the U.S., marking a moment of needed relief for many of our fellow Americans. While there is an air of elation around us, let us take time to give pause and reflect and honor our fallen brothers and sisters, reminding everyone of the selfless sacrifices that secured the freedom we enjoy. May we continue to honor their legacy, living lives worthy of those who laid down their lives for us. Thank you. Thank you. We will now have our opening ceremony. We'll have the Peters Township High School Mighty Indian Marching Band under the direction of Director John McKay and Co-Director Spencer Coon. We'll have the flag raising from Post Commander Gary MacArthur.
Sisters
who have laid down their lives in service of our country. May they rest in peace and may light perpetual shine upon them. May the good work of seeking justice for the oppressed and peace for all mankind be rewarded with success, that their sacrifices shall not have been in vain. And may we never fail to remember the awesome cost of the freedom which we enjoy. Amen.
Amen.
We will now have the placing of the wreath. Gary MacArthur, Post Commander, and Royland Smith, Junior Vice President of the Auxiliary. We will now have a 21-gun salute under the direction of Tom Talon, Chief Warrant Officer, U.S. Army retired. After the 21-gun salute, we will have the taps.
First of all, I'd like to thank everybody for taking time out of their busy schedule to come here today. We're here to congratulate and celebrate with the winners of the Patriots Pen and the Voice of the Democracy essay contest. First, I'd like to recognize some individuals here on the stage and in the audience. Post Commander Gary MacArthur. Former Post and State Commander Dominic DeFranco. Smith, Junior Vice President of the Auxiliary. Unfortunately, Sandy Roberto, the President, was not able to make it today. She had a knee replacement. She's a dentist. excuse not being here. Chaplain Brian DeLong. Lieutenant Colonel Jim Kukuzinski. And our guest speaker, U.S. Navy Commander Walter Schratz, U.S. Navy Reserve. Memorial Day, as Decoration Day gradually became to be known, originally honored only those lost while fighting in the Civil War. But during World War I, the United States found itself embroiled in another major conflict, and the holiday evolved to commemorate American military personnel who died in all wars, including World War II, the Vietnam War, the Korean Wars, and the wars in Iraq and Afghanistan. The Patriots Pen and the Voice of the Democracy are essay contests that the VS sponsors every year. The Patriots Pen is open to students in grades 6 through 8 and gives the students an opportunity to write an essay expressing their views on an annual patriotic theme. This year's theme was, What is Patriotism to Me? The Voice of the Democracy is open to students in grades 9 through 12. Since 1947, the Voice of the Democracy has been the Veterans of Foreign Wars premier scholarship program. Each year, nearly 50,000 students compete for more than $2 million in scholarships and incentives. Students compete by writing and reading an audio essay on an annual patriotic theme. This year's theme was, Is This the Country the Founders had Envisioned? Okay, I'm gonna start with the Patriot Pen winners. Third place is Jack Fazio. Jack also took third place at the district level. Second place winner was Christopher McKay. He's not here today. I believe he's in Chicago visiting his sister that he hasn't seen for a couple years. And the first place winner at the post level and at the district level is Allison Bentz. Allison will come up and receive her certificate, and she will read her winning essay. Third place was Caitlin Stokin. Caitlin also placed first at the district and sixth at the state level. Second place goes to Zach Bowers. And this year's winner of the Voice of the Democracy was Joseph Waseka, and Joseph also placed second at the district level.
Is this the country that the founders envisioned? Unequivocally, yes. The United States is just how its founders envisioned it. This response may seem surprising with the pandemic, economic devastation, and social unrest throughout the country. Though these specific hardships may not be predictable, the forefathers understood the importance of equipping future generations with fundamental laws to guide them through trying times. This guide is known as the United States Constitution. It has stood the test of time and maintained America as the greatest country in the world. It was designed to help future generations navigate through challenges while safeguarding the fundamental rights of all individuals. It is the individual liberties provided in these founding documents that will ultimately prevail and allow the country to overcome the challenges of society today. Though the United States is in the midst of many struggles, it is still the world's best hope for advancing civil liberties and truths held to be self-evident. To acknowledge a nation's failings and taking responsibility for improving society would not only be how Thomas Jefferson envisioned America, it would also make him proud. He was quoted as having said, "Dissent is the highest form of patriotism. It is this form of patriotism, in conjunction with the Constitution, that is responsible for the country's long-term success. This is how America progresses. This is how America will continue to succeed. This is how America gets better." Washington, Jefferson, Adams, Madison, and their fellow founders were courageous patriots who put country above all else. They certainly wouldn't prefer the current upheaval and uncertainty in the country. Tensions amongst neighbors in the middle of a pandemic, police brutality, racial inequality, disdain with past and present administrations, the media in question, and never mind the social media disputes that have everyone weighing in on how the government should respond. All the issues are unfortunately a sign of the times. However, the government nor social media are going to resolve them. It's the fortitude and wisdom of the American founders and the resilience and ingenuity of the American people that will get the American country back on track and emerge even stronger than before. The current challenges are significant, but the country has endured far worse realities in the past. America is secure in the long-standing principles and exceptional visionaries who have put the country first, making founders proud and proving the United States as a nation of greatness. In the words first drafted by Thomas Jefferson, "We hold these truths to be self-evident, that all men are created equal, that they are endowed by the Creator with certain unalienable rights, that among these are life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness." As the country continues to ensure these rights, things may not be perfect. However, the United States is still the greatest nation, greatest country in the world, just how its founders envisioned it.
I'd also like to thank Harry Bushmeyer from the grade school and Katrina Danella from the high school that were instrumental in this program. Just a reminder to all students in 6th through 8th grade, the Patriots Pen essay is around October. The deadline, I think, is usually the end of October. So if you don't hear anything about it in school, you can either call the post and you'll get in touch with me or talk to Mr. Bushmeyer. And Katrina Danella, she wasn't the high school. She was, I believe, a guidance counselor or in the office. But she moved over to the bus depot. So I'm not too sure who the point of contact is at the high school level. And that's for 9th through 12th grade. The same thing applies. The deadline is usually around October 31st. So if you want to participate in it, there will be information at the schools. And if not, you can call the post. And if you can
Now we're gonna take a little break and listen to some fine music by the Peters Township Marching Band and their rendition.
Post 764. It is my honor to introduce Commander Schratz. Certainly, I'm glad you were able to snag me for this. Welcome to today's ceremony, and I am humbled and honored to provide 2021's keynote address. I feel like I'm doing 2 years in one with the pandemic of 2020 that robbed us of last year's celebration and our recognition of those who gave so much for us to have the liberties and freedoms we enjoy today. I would also like to thank Lieutenant Colonel Coco, as they say, and the Planning Committee for extending me an invitation to be here today. As a Peters Township resident for over 32 years, I have been to many of these memorial services that were all unique in many ways and in their own right, but I don't recall the last time a healthcare provider has presented this address. So given all that has taken place in the last 12 months, maybe it's appropriate that I, as a healthcare provider myself, was chosen to give this speech. Last year indeed was catastrophic in many, many ways, and the full impact may take years to be known. Yet history was made in our efforts to support this country's war against COVID. And war was indeed, for you see, there were no hard targets downfield on the battlefield or in the seas or in the skies above. No, this enemy was unseen, but just as lethal, compromising our daily lives that we often take for granted. Despite all these events of the past year, our focus still is and must remain the same. To gather here on this solemn occasion, to stand in acknowledgement and remember those servicemen and women and the sacrifices they made for this glorious country, made with honor and dignity. Despite differences in color, faith, or religion, they all possess several fundamental qualities: courage, pride, and a dedication to duty with integrity. They were ordinary people who responded in an extraordinary way in the face of adversity and death. Most volunteered, but not knowing where or when they were to give the total gift of their life for the many. Today is no different. When the first shots were fired at Concord or Lexington during the Revolutionary War, our men and women continue to answer our nation's call to duty. Millions have fought here and abroad, on every continent, and on every soil on earth. They all follow in the footsteps of those who have gone before them. They were all called by something bigger than themselves. Let us take a moment to reflect on the origins of today's occasion. Memorial Day arose from the Civil War, a war with approximately 620,000 killed and many, many thousands injured or maimed. A popular version goes as follows. During the Civil War, a war fought on our own soil, a war that tore families apart, and a war that left cities burning. Bullets from that war ravaged homes, schools, churches, and cities. This war was filled with carnage and destruction not ever seen in this nation before. From those dark, sorrowful times were the families who sought to recognize those who paid the ultimate price. In Charleston, South Carolina, freed slaves began decorating the graves of both the Union and Confederate soldiers out of respect for the Union troops, hoping the same would occur in the North. As these events traversed the country, this led to the first formal Memorial Day observed in Waterloo, New York, on May 5, 1866. Congress officially recognized Memorial Day in 1877, but it wasn't until President Johnson in 1966 made it a federal holiday, the last Monday in May. So, these simple acts of decorating the graves of those that sacrificed their life united for our nation for years to come in the spirit of unity. This act of celebrating Memorial Day grew with each war that claimed many thousands of soldiers, sailors, airmen, and Marines. What does sacrifice mean? To suffer loss of, to give of oneself. Well, we certainly can say one's life is the ultimate sacrifice that these individuals displayed and continue to this day. I'd like to acknowledge everyone's presence today, and to those families across America whose son or daughter gave of themselves. It's a fitting tribute to those lost troops who served here and abroad. My fervent hope is that we can continue to gather this way for generations to come. For you see, it's vitally important that we as a nation remember. Remember your loved ones as well as those just doing their part to honor their supreme sacrifice. Despite all the medals, ribbons, and monuments, nothing can adequately comfort those left behind grieving. It is also fitting we mention all veterans and service members in attendance today. For your call to duty, you have contributed mightily to making our armed forces the most respected in the world. Thank you. And a special thank you to your families for their patience and understanding while you serve. Often overlooked, but not without our utmost respect for shouldering the load and keeping the home fires burning. I can say unequivocally that without your support and love, we would be lost. I would like to end with quoting two famous historical figures whose names are held with high honor and distinction for their leadership and belief in this country's sanctity of our democracy. First, to paraphrase General George Patton, who stated, "It is foolish and wrong to mourn the death of men and women who died. Rather, we should thank God that such men and women have lived." And finally, in the immortal words of our 16th President of the United States, Abraham Lincoln, with his Gettysburg Address, "It is rather here for us to be dedicated to the great task remaining before us, that from these honored dead, we take increased devotion to that cause for which they gave their last full measure of devotion, that we here highly resolve that these dead should not have died in vain." Thank you for everyone attending today, pausing in your daily life to acknowledge and reflect on the immense importance of today. God bless you and your families, and may God bless our troops, and may God bless America. Thank you.
Closing remarks now from the Post Commander, Gary MacArthur.
In closing, I'd like to thank everybody for coming. We would like you, as the Post, to take a tour through our Post and see some of the commemorative walls that we have in the dining area. Also, if you go through, we also have some refreshments out on the patio area, so please help yourself. We thank you all for coming, and we'll have to look after the young man there in the front. Thank you.
All right, is the ambulance still here?
No.
We will now have the benediction from Post Chaplain Brian DeLong.
nations, we pause at the end of this gathering to acknowledge again your sovereignty over our lives and our country. We remember before you our comrades now departed this life. We honor them for their loyalty to God and country, for their good deeds, and for their friendship. May they rest in peace, and may the good works you have begun in them be brought to perfection, that our nation may be strong and our people secure and happy. Give to us safe journeys to our homes. Amen. With all of our fallen heroes and their families in mind, I ask that before each of you leave here today, you make yourself one promise. And that promise is, you will never forget. God bless all of our departed heroes, their families, and God bless America.